看，
不是，你得往左边再过去。
Welcome to the press conference with Edward Gaming. We will start. You could either raise your hand or text in the chat box. We will call on you. Are there any questions online? We'll start with the question in the room.
请问教练，那这场比赛能不能总结一下你们在哪些方面还需要提高的？谢谢。
我感觉是我们拿到优势之后的心态转变吧，可能就是还需要记住我们是怎么拿下那些关键的分数的，然后记住那个感觉，不要让后面就是强势变失败的变奏来被影响到，让我们忘记了原来的得分方式吧。
So the question is for Coach Mogul. Could you please like sum up how could team to improving yourself? And Mogul's answer was that trying to remember those. I think we should focus on how to keep our mentality stable when we get our lead up in the round, and trying to remember how to get points when you got your advantage in this round, and don't get when your opponent change your pace. Don't let them to destroy your pace. Okay, next question goes to Pedro Romero.
Hey guys, first off, congratulations on the loss. Got a question for Kang Kang. Obviously, the team started off well in the first map, winning an icebox, and then obviously losing the next two ensuing maps in Haven and Bind. What changed for the team, from your point of view, from the end of map one up until the very end that kind of caused the loss to happen?
这个问题是想要问到康康选手，其实今天在图一的时候是拿到了胜利吗？但是在图二、图三可能并没有取得一个好的结果，你觉得是发生了什么转变，或者是原因是什么呢？
我觉得应该是拿到领先的时候，就可能大家都有点急吧，然后那个时候可能大家都很想快一点结束下来这场比赛，所以说就可能导致大家的动作啊跟一些行为上可能会就是有点操之过急吧，包括我在内，我可能也要更注意这些东西吧。对，然后我觉得这可能是我们输的一个关键点吧，就是可能拿到优先领先的时候可能有点急，对。
So Kanka's answer was that when we take a lead, we kind of like too hurry to get next point. Everyone was like, hurry up, we are too like in too hurried and too harsh in the harsh to get next point. That kind of caused our action and performance in the server a bit too hurry, and including me myself, we should be focused on when we take a lead in the server, we should be focused on how to keep our mentality stable and don't be too hurrying the game. That's the key point for us. Thank you. Next question goes to Sports Kida.
Hello, congratulations on the loss today. I'd like to ask this question to Simon. Despite the loss today, you had a really good performance for a rookie on the international stage. So, how comfortable do you feel on such a big event? And yeah, how happy are you with your individual performance today?
这个问题是想问到 Simon 选手，其实除了今天可能很可惜并没有拿下胜利之外，你个人的表现也是很棒的嘛。那能不能和我们讲讲，就是在这么大的世界赛事上，今天表现也是不错，感受整体怎么样？
问感受吗？
感受以及你就是对今天的表现，你觉得满意吗？开心吗？这种。
对自己的还行吧，挺满意的，但是就比较可惜，就输了。
I'm okay with my performance today, but it's still what a pity about today's loss.
Thank you, and good luck in the next game.
Thank you. Next question goes to Sense of Chaos.
Hello, everyone. Thanks for the opportunity to ask a question. Congratulations on the loss today, guys. My question is for anyone who wants to answer. What would you say that was the most surprising thing about this G2 team that caught you off guard?
这个问题谁都可以回答。那在今天的比赛当中，觉得 G2 他们带给你们就是最惊喜的一部分，能够就是比如说让你们措手不及的那样的一个部分是哪里呢？
我感觉是他们可能就是选手个人明白自己什么时候该打明星球，就这一点吧。他们单点逆转局势的分数有一点多，超乎我们预料的多了。
I think it's because they're individually, they know when should they stand up for the team. And in today's major matchup, I think our opponent have so much unexpected 1-on-3 or 1-on-2 that they get point that we didn't expect that.
Thank you, and good luck in the coming matches.
Thank you. Next question goes to Dafiki.
Thank you. I'm Sepiki. I'm sorry for the defeat. This question is for everyone. Despite today's defeat, is there anything positive you can take away from this match? Thank you.
这个问题谁都可以回答。那就是除了今天比较可惜的没有拿到一个好成果之外，大家觉得有没有哪一个部分是觉得是正向的一个收获呢？通过今天的比赛。
我觉得今天这个结果虽然不好，但是我觉得我们应该还是都能接受的，因为毕竟 G2 也算是国内，对，也算是世界的一线强队了，而且我觉得是有争冠实力的队伍。然后我们能跟他们打得这么接近、焦灼的情况下，就是至少能给我们一个定心丸，就是我们现在 CN 瓦罗兰的队伍也是可以跟国际的强队掰掰手腕的。
Despite the bad results today, we think it's kind of like acceptable because, G2 is a super strong team. We also think he's one of the favorites in this tournament. So we are so close today. So that kind of make a improvement that CN Leagues also got the power to fight against with other league.
Thank you. We'll have the last question from Pedro Romero.
Yes.
Hello, Pedro.
Hello?
Hello. Oh, we can hear
Hello.
you now.
Okay. All right. Sorry about that. I got a question for the coach. For map two, G2 opted a new composition, adopting the Yoru and other agents of that nature, in that part of the series. I want to know from your perspective, what was your reaction to it? How did you kind of direct or lead the team to playing against it? And what was the biggest issues that you found that kind of prohibited the team from winning that map with that in mind?
这个问题是想问到 Margo 教练，那在图二的时候，对方也是做了一个辩证嘛，拿了夜路出来，那你当时是如何对这个点来进行一个反应和调整的呢？那你觉得，没有最后拿下这张图的最重要的一个阻止你们的因素是什么呢？
我感觉他们这张图的夜路体系玩的好像还没有那么熟练，然后我们打他们反制方式就是，我们只有一时间和最后一波大概剩30秒的这种便秘时间的这种进攻方式，然后就是要么快节奏，要么就是慢节奏，然后要把你那个可能前压的优乳一点一点给他拍回去，就 基本上这种模式，然后后面没有拿下，我觉得就是跟我之前前面说的一样，我们在中间自己变换节奏之后，可能那些分运气不好没有成功，但是之后我们会就是下一分的时候会忘记之前的拿分方式是什么。
And so his answer was that feel like they're not really familiar and super good at their comps right now. So our method is basically like when there was 30 seconds left and we kind of starting our attack game. And when they're really trying to pushing forward and we just like attacking and fight back. So that kind of like our way. And if you talk about like, what's the key point that we lost today? I think it's because like during the middle of the series of this map, we change our pace. So like we're unlucky to get those points we should have, and we just lost our pace. So we need to get back when we're starting a new round and don't let the emotion last, the bad mood last to the next round.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, EDG. Well, this concludes our press conference with EDG today. Good luck to your next match.